Okay, so I'm doing this checkpoint thing. Yeah. Because no one else seems to be doing it. As you can see, I ground some money.
Oh my God.
Got myself one of these desert raids. It seemed like since I had just popped in and they just started this checkpoint thing, it'd be a good thing to do. As you can see, it's taken some damage. The parts do seem to fall off of it pretty quickly. But that actually makes it a little easier to drive, because it is huge. And it looks like these checkpoints are all a little buried. Let's see, where do we... The only modification I've made to it so far is the race suspension, which oddly enough lowers it. Can we get through here? No, we can't. We have to hop out and ugh, all there. Look, see all that blood? Oh, that's just disgusting. And hop. And we'll run in here. And, ooh, 5. Like, I'm so in the lead. No one else is trying. In like 4 minutes, I should just win this, and... You know what I should do? I think we should invoke some CEO-ness here. CEO vehicles... Would you please bring me... Oh, come on, where's my buzzard? There we go. And... There it is! Just have to hop over the thing again. I wonder why that was grayed out. If you're gonna do this, I mean, you know, obviously, a little bit of style is probably a good idea. Okay, what's the closest one here? We only need to pad this a little bit. Oh, look, perfect. Perfect thing for a buzzard. Let's see if I can avoid crashing it into a hillside. Back it up. It's gonna take 20 minutes to get one checkpoint. This seems like an intrinsically bad idea. It's like the way to do this, yet not. It's the way to do it if you were good. Can we get it? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Come on. A little more thrust. A little less talk, a little more action. Oh, come on! Uh-oh, Fishball 69's trying to catch up with me. Very soon I have to abandon this little checkpoint. Come on, drop it. You gotta be kidding me. Okay, now the buzzard's hurt. I'm giving up on that. That one. We should be able to do that one. Ooh, leave that one there. I really suck at this. Okay, let's get out. Get number 6. And you wanna know what? We're gonna see if we can get all CEO with on ourselves here. Just getting down with our... Give me BJ here. Your vehicle is close to your organization. Nice. Okay, well, what if we do this the old-fashioned way?
Shit, sorry, I can't get there at the moment.
I'm off in the middle of nowhere, great. I'm gonna lose here, so now I gotta depend on the buzzard. Guess he can't bring a car up this way. The buzzard's already smoking. What happens if I blow up my buzzard? Come on, we can't let Fishball 69 beat us. Where is the nearest? There, nice open area. Let's just cut the engines and head down. Get out here. You won checkpoints with a score of 6. I beat him by 1, and I got $4,000 and I'm... And I blew... I wrecked the... I'm stuck in a hole. But look at that. I made $4,000. Let's race. We need to race. That's the only thing that's going to help. Normally, I don't like off-the-off-roaders. Let's see. Afterburner, but... The only one I know of is Turbine. Are there any others? Vinewood Downhill? I think that's motorcycles. Let's do Turbine, because we know it's... Again, the only thing I've done is drop the suspension. I gave it a racing suspension. Because I have no money. With that $4,000, I think I have maybe $10,000. I've spent all of it. Confirm settings. Let's play it alone. Just see how this thing handles. Get a little feel to it. No, we don't want that. You can drive the Insurgent. The Insurgent is an option. Oh, what do I do now? Let's run the Insurgent just to see how it feels. Now, obviously, I haven't done a lot to this other than put the windows on. This is a stock Insurgent. Look at this. It's huge. Can you even run an Insurgent through the track? Will it fit? Will it fit through the hole? Just. How does it handle? Had a lift there a little bit. Now, I gotta tell you, I have a feeling this would get crushed in a race because it's just so darn slow. Even if I bump this up, it's not gonna be raceable. But the fact that you can... What happens if this gets hit by one of the wind blades? Will it make jumps? Okay, this is maximum performance here. Made it through. It's a heavy thing. I'm mesmerized. I'm completely mesmerized watching this beast drive around here. It's not hard to drive. And even the Insurgent gets knocked down, but it gets right back up. No damage whatsoever. I'll tell you what, that was less of an impact than I've had many times. You know, just... Down and up, that's not that bad a deal. around and around. I don't know that this would be terrible if it was up to, you know, it was brought up to date, if we got it, you know. I mean, I do have all the engine tuning into it. I don't have a turbo, but it is engine tuned. If I don't know if we can change the suspension on it. But can you imagine? Just running this thing around, no one's gonna bump you. You'll be last anyway, they don't need to bump you, but I almost have to try that. I almost have to try Turbine with the Insurgent. Turbine with the Insurgent. Ooh, we landed on the rail there, and it still didn't phase it. Oh, I forgot to make it one lap. Last fuel will still be able to pull a time out of this, really. So you're still looking like a 3 minute 35 second time on this. When we come around the next time, we'll let it run out to 8 and then cash it out, because I am poor at this moment. I've got lots of stuff, but I've got no credits whatsoever. It would be really hard to pass. Comment in the description below if you've ever raced an Insurgent and won. I don't know. I mean, not that you've raced against an Insurgent one. That wouldn't be that big a deal, because it's not very fast. But, I mean, as far as if you've ever hopped in one of these, gone into a race against, you know, fast cars, and either through, you know, cruelty or sheer luck, managed to come across first. I'd save that for another... This really does just go over everything, though. There's not a lot of... Not a lot of finesse required. I think short of driving it off the cliff, you're not going to have a problem. Go Insurgent! If you want to be the type of person who just, look at that, swats it down, right back up again. Right back up again, and back into the race. The wrong way, maybe, but... Not too bad, not really any kind of visible damage. For getting swatted out of the sky. It's the Insurgent! Ba-dum-da-dum-dum-dum! Whee! I do like this, Oh, we do have a little mark on it, look! We did get one little mark on the top. I'm getting hit by, you know, one of the windmills of power. Real life, that would have snapped that windmill right in half. Knocked the blade right the heck off of it, then it would have gone into oscillations because it would have been unbalanced. Destroyed it. That's what would have happened. But let's be honest, Grand Theft Auto is not real life. It may be someone's interpretation of what hell would be like. You know, just like regular life, except there's no kids anywhere, and everyone likes to kill each other, but you can never really die. You just keep coming back and getting shot over and over again. You get teleported to these strange challenges that couldn't really exist in real life because, you know, they're just laid over the streets of the town like this. I mean, it's all bizarre. And as the fireworks go off, we hit the brakes and we sing, "Let's do the time warp again." And here we are, 8 minutes, yay! And then this thing's gonna make me the $16,000 because we're still in the double money period, yes. Alrighty then. So, there you go. Best lap, 323.9. Not belated. Now let's see. Let's see if we could let's free mode this for a moment. Hold on. We'll be right back. Now, same track with the slightly handling improved desert rate at the racing suspension. Same stock motor though. The Insurgent had the engine maxed out but no turbo. I don't know which one actually looks bigger. This is, I think it has to zoom back for the Insurgent. Well, let's just see what kind of a difference we have here. Obviously, you know, the Desert Raid is a faster car by, a lot. But, for my skill level, will I screw this up enough that the other one, I can't beat 323 in the first lap? As far as plans for this car, I do plan on switching it to the drone livery with the yellow paint. I didn't know you could do that. I thought the orange was part of the livery, but that actually gives it a little bit more black. So, a better black-yellow balance for my standard, Steelers livery cars. Right, we made it through there. Handles nice. I have to say, I like to feel this better than any of the other ones I've driven. The stock ones that you rent. It's definitely more planted. I'm going around this turn easier than some of the sports cars. Of course, the sports cars are going a lot faster. But it's definitely, it's not bad. It's big. It is big. I mean, you look at this. If anyone tried to fast me, they'd have to hit me. I think if you really want to be competitive, you need a motorcycle. And from what I've been seeing online... Ooh! Now there's a real test. Now you see how much longer... Of course, we landed on our wheels, so that helps. This is a pretty tough truck, too, so it'll be interesting to see. How much slower the Insurgent is. I expect it to be slower. And, it's a fair comparison, because they both had a smackdown from the actual windmills. Ooh, just cleared that. Come on, we want to get through here, yay! Oh, I just realized that turbine knocked one of my spare tires away. You see, I didn't know that was a possibility. Okay, so it looks like it's beating it, but I mean, is it beating it by a lot? 323 to beat, folks. So it beat it by 21 seconds only. Which I would have thought that would have been a bigger deal, but no, 23 seconds is the difference. Which if you go off once, then you're toast. Now, I mean, I think probably if I was doing this in a BF400, maybe we'll do that next. See, that'll be our third race for this video. Three solos, what do you think, gang? And we're zipping around here. I can tell you how the rest of it's gonna go. We're gonna park this out front of the thing. Whee! Now it was almost, of course, to 7 minutes when we can clear it! Alright! When we parked the other one. How long? We have to wait a lot longer for the... Whoa! It's walking on me. For the Badger, I would think so. Hopefully we'll have a bigger time warp this time. I wonder where my tire went. Turboing up. Zing-a-boink. It's such a big truck, too. I mean, the Insurgent, I believe, is bigger. Clear this! Yay! That will help. Not really, if it bounces to heck on the way down. That, wow! Very bouncy there. That's gonna hurt the time. So does that mean that the Insurgent may be something we can work with? I don't know. We could turbo it, make it a little faster. If the turbo does, if we haven't maxed out the acceleration for that particular chassis. Or chassis. Coming around here, yeah, it looks like we'll have... depends, do I wreck it here? Certainly nothing is as planted and heavy as the Insurgent as far as what you're going to bring to a race. If I wanted to, I could go into a race and just start hitting everybody right at the start and just keep them all... Find a choke point somewhere and park it across the ramp. Have people just keep ramming into me. Like if you put it right there. 6:09, so we get about a minute faster. There she is. Remember, support America. Use foreign oil. Which is probably, you could probably speak to a philosophy of that. Like, if you use all the foreign people's oil up, well, then we still have oil. Ha ha! And they'll have no oil. And anybody here played the Fallout series? That's kind of how that goes. But let's do the time warp again. Oop! Oh, that's a little glitched out. Come on. Oh, that's just beautiful. I think for at least a little while, I won't do a whole lot different with the look. I'm going to even keep the stock livery, just so people think that they're racing a stock vehicle. Okay, I think we should do one more thing here. Now, this is the BF400. Does it even give you the option for the Sanchez on this one? So we're going to try and see what's the difference here. What's the time difference if you have a BF400? Completely stock, mind you. Completely different feel to everything now. And really, you know, I'm only going to hold you through the... Well, I guess we should really go through the... through the same thing. We'll keep this scientific. Now, I can only imagine if you have a hyped-up BF400, what that would gain you. I plan on getting one, really. It does look a little more fancy-dancy than the Sanchez does. And of course, it avoids, you know, the name pun kind of thing there. It's not going to go into that because, you know. Whee! We go. Obviously, it takes a little bit more finesse to hustle this puppy around. And I'm really kind of curious what's going to happen when I get hit with that blade coming through here, if I get hit with the blade. And here we go! Well, that's actually not All right, that was pretty bad. But where are we? Okay. It didn't, like, smack me in the head and kill me, so that was good. Yeah, as far... Nah, I'm not even gonna go there. All I'm saying is that there is an expression that would be akin to a dirt bike named Sanchez, which is, yes, quite frankly, quite racist and offensive, and I'm pretty sure that's where they were going with it, but I hope not, you know, it's... Whoa! That was different. And I'm dead. Ow. So that will cost me some time. I still remember when I found out about that terminology. I was in my 30s, and I was completely horrified. And yet, you shouldn't. Don't. Anyway, I'm buying the BF400 instead. So that's the whole idea, because you don't want to support these kind of things, really. I mean, it's just... Well, this is kind of interesting. This is kind of interesting. I was significantly slower than the Desert Raid. That's a 318. Maybe I don't need to buy a bike. Huh. It could be that I'm just terrible at bikes. But between getting swatted down and kind of losing control and then wrecking going around the loop here... But you wouldn't get killed going around the loop like that, necessarily, in a truck. And would a maxed out BF400 be different? Would that be a different tune? That'll have to find out. Maybe someday we'll do a maxed out... Oh, dear. Yeah, swatted down. Well, this is bad. Can I get back up? Can we get... up on the thing with the other... And... Oh, yes, we can. We can drive all the way around. See? It's not so bad. It's... You know what? I'm not gonna do the time warp again thing. I'm gonna take this through and see if we could pull off one better lap than the 318, even with that little... Even so, it's not, you know, both of them, you know, it'd be apples and oranges, because this would be a rolling start to the lap versus a static start, but I don't think it's going to pull it off. Missed me. Gaboink. So we're going to give up the big bucks here, even though I need the big bucks. But we're still going to have some bucks here, because we're already at 5 minutes. But we need to do some science. Science is what we're trying to do here. Everyone swears by the motorcycles. Which, it's possible that I simply suck on motorcycles. I think the fact that the Raid is competitive with the bike, and really, I mean, the bike only beat the Insurgent by 5 seconds because of incidents on the track. I think there's going to have to be some science here. Time was 6:23. Alright, we're still getting 13,000, man. Not bad. And we leveled to 150 doing science. Let's see, what's the best lap? My best lap was a 305, which was comparable to the roll and start lap on the other one, on the Desert Raid. That's interesting, folks. And on that moment of interestingness, this is the Black Knight.